Your weight is already low, then you need not worry about that. And milk is to give you a certain kind of, again, a certain protein or whatever the milk is. If you have plenty of those, then you need not worry about that. And so idea is that each one of these three gives different result, and therefore there is no sequence that first you do jogging and then drink milk and then take quinine. He says, why should I take quinine? You know, there is no sequence expected because you are not interested in that phala. So, if you are interested in phala, then alone you to perform that action. When phala is, yes, it is, sometimes happens that you must drink milk before taking quinine, they say. Because both of them give one result. If you take quinine without milk, then all kind of intestine problem. If you take milk without the quinine, then all kind of stomach problem. And so you must take milk and quinine to avoid problem. In that case, then ek phalakatvam is there. Then a sequence is involved. Should I take quinine first or milk first? Baba, take milk first. The quinine will destroy your stomach and then milk will come out, you know, and whatever. So then sequence is involved. But if you are taking one phala, then sequence is involved. Different phalas, sequence is not involved. So dharma, jignasa and brahma jignasa give rise to different phalas, and therefore no sequence is called for. And then jignasya vishaya bheda, he gives a wonderful illustration. Yathava kama chikitsa tantra, kama chikitsa tantra, there is a kama tantra and chikitsa tantra. Kama shastra stri rupaha, kama jignasya, kamya deidi kama vishaya, chikitsa shastra shariram jignasyam. So different shastras have different vishayas, you know. And there also there is no sequence that you must first study kama shastra, then chikitsa shastra. No such sequence there, because they address themselves to independent vishayas. So iti phala bhedat or jignasa bhedat na eka kartrukatvam ataha na kramapeksha. Idea is when different actions give rise to different phala, all in physics give rise to one and chemistry is another subject. There is no sequence that you must first study geography and then study chemistry. Because geography is one vishaya, chemistry is another vishaya. No sequence is expected, thank God. But if you want to study engineering, then you must study mathematics, because that mathematics prepares ground for engineering. In that case, a sequence is required. But mathematics has no relation with medicine. And therefore, in fact, one is opposed to other anyway. If you are good in mathematics, then you cannot be good in medicine or the counting bones, etc. And if you are good there, you cannot be good here. That seems to be my practical experience anyway. But then the idea is, if your mind works in a certain way, it just doesn't work in another way. Works in some way, it does not work in another way. So when jignasya vishaya is different, no krama is expected. But when vishaya is one, then krama is expected. This is the point here. So tadvat mimamsayoho na krama apeksha iti bhava. And similarly, dharma brahma mimamsayoho krama apeksha na iti. Okay, I think Bhashyakara's discussion will take up tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Mukarascata Shandascha Dvavetav Brahmanah Pura Kantham Vipva Viniryatav Tasman Mangalika Vuhau Om Atha Om Atha Om Atha Pratya Gochara Yoho
Vishwanasmat Pratya Gochara Yoho
Vishay Vishayinoho Tamah Prakashavad Virudhya Subhava Yoho Itar Itar Bhavan Upattav Siddhayam Tad Dharmanam Api Sutaram Itar Itar Bhavan Upattihi Nityadah Tasmat Pratyay Gochare Vishayini Chidatmake Yushmat Pratyay Gocharasya विषयस्य तद्धर्माणां च अभ्यासः तद्विपर्येण विषयिणः तद्धर्माणां च विषये अभ्यासः मिथ्येति भवितुं युक्तम् या शिक्षासि तस्य इदमादिवं सूत्रम् अथातो ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा। फ्रॉम पेज 71 परम ब्रह्म जिज्ञासयोः फल जिज्ञास्य भेदाच्च। The meaning we were atha in the sutra is being discussed here, and the last point that was made is that atha should mean krama, a sequence. We said yesterday that the sequence is expected where eka kartrukatvam is there, when one person has to perform several functions, and since several functions cannot be performed simultaneously, then there is always an expectation on the part of the listener as to what is the sequence in which those functions should be performed. And then the need for sequence is there, and thereby the statement of sequence also will be there. However, between dharma jignyasa and karma jignyasa and brahma jignyasa, such relationship as adhikrata adhikara or shesha sheshi bhava, those relationships which require ekakartrukatvam, the performance by one person alone, such relationships not being there, atha in this particular case cannot mean krama or sequence. Then they say, well, there is another instance also where atha can mean the sequence or krama. When is it? Where the phala and the vishaya, both of them are one. Now the contention here is that both dharma jignyasa and brahma jignyasa, both of them are addressing to one subject alone. The theme or the subject matter of dharma jignyasa, meaning inquiry into dharma, and brahma jignyasa, inquiry into brahma, is both one, and there is vedartha. Dharma also is vedartha, meaning something expounded by Veda, and brahma also is vedartha, something expounded by Veda, and therefore, both being vedartha, we would say that the subject matter is the same. And phala also is the same. Why? Because the samuchyavadi is the same. That jnana karma bhyam mukti, that mukti or moksha is only by samuchya or a combination of jnana and karma. And therefore, merely jnana or merely karma cannot give rise to moksha. This is what the samuchyavadins believe. And so, phala also is one, namely moksha. And so, jignyasyam meaning vishaya and phala, namely the result, both of them being one, we say that dharma jignyasa and brahma jignyasa, both of them must have a karma. Just as when the phala is one, in case of all these, the different kind of yagas were being given here, this agneya, the shad yaganam, so different yagas are there, all of them in combination give rise to one phala, namely swarga. In that case, there is a need for knowing the sequence of how to perform those various yagas. And when the subject matter is one, then also there is an expectation or a need to know the sequence. Like the Purva Mimamsa, like any Shastra, Purva Mimamsa is an illustration. It consists of 12 chapters. All those 12 chapters expound only one subject matter, namely Dharma. And when that is so, there is always what the first chapter gives becomes the ground for the second chapter, and that becomes the basis for the third chapter, and therefore there is always a need for sequence. First chapter, second chapter, third chapter. Similarly also Vedartha, what the Veda has to expound being the subject matter of Dharma Jignyasa and Brahma Jignyasa, we say that Dharma Jignyasa is the first chapter, Brahma Jignyasa is second chapter, and so second chapter in Brahma Jignyasa will require the background of the first chapter. Therefore, atha should mean krama. And phala also is moksha, therefore also both of them should be performed simultaneously, therefore also krama is vivakshita. And so, atha should mean krama. This was the purapaksha. And the answer that was given is, no, phala bhedat jignyasya bhedat cha. The phala of both dharma and brahma jignyasa is different, and jignyasya, meaning the vishaya also is different. And how? So, there now, page 74 in the last line, Ratna Prabha says, tatra phalabhedam vivranoti. What is tatra? Phalabheda jignyasya bheda yoho madhye. So, there is that there are two kinds of bhedas or two kinds of distinctions are there between dharma jignyasa and brahma jignyasa, that the phala also is altogether different, the result that they give rise to is quite different, and the subject matter also is entirely of different nature. This distinction. So what happens is, by way of raising different purupakshas and answering them, what is being done here is that the nature of dharma and brahma is something that is being clarified before us. So whether or not someone asks this question, but the very answer serves the purpose of creating a clarity in our mind about the nature of dharma and brahman. So dharma also has a place in life, we should know that. And what dharma can accomplish and what is the nature of dharma, that we should know. And of course brahma has place in life and we should know how to approach that. So if you know the nature or the distinction in the nature of the two, then you know how to approach them, how to deal with them and how to implement them. So that purpose also is being served by this discussion here. Idea is, in each one of the discussion, even though the questions or the doubt may appear to be technical, but discussion only has one purpose, namely Brahma Jignyasa. Understand that in and through all this discussion also, whether it is discussion of the word Atha or whatever it is, what is really being done is only Brahma Jignyasa or Brahma Vichara. But Brahma Vichara also requires the Vichara about other things which are different from Brahma, in order that we understand the nature of Brahma in reference to other things. So all what is being done here is only Brahma Vichara. Somebody may think this is all technical thing. What does it have to do with Brahma? It does. Because dharma is something that is relevant in our life, which we are following. So with reference to that, how is Brahma placed with reference to dharma? Dharma gives rise to one kind of result. Brahma Jignyasa gives rise to another kind of result. Why? Because nature of dharma and Brahma are different. So thus, in that sense, the nature of Brahman is being revealed here in reference to and in light of the nature of dharma. And so directly or indirectly, all this is only Brahma Jignyasa. Otherwise it would not have place in this discussion here. We are not interested in trying to quieten the Mimamsakas, etc. We are only interested in knowing Brahman. And all of this is helpful in understanding that. Tatra phalabhedam vivranoti. We said that the phala is different and the vishaya also is different. So first of all, Vashyagara points out phala veda. How the phala or the result occurring from dharma jignyasa and brahma jignyasa, how the result is different is first being vivranati, is first being explained here, abhyudayati. Says Vashyagara, abhyudaya phalam dharma jnanam tajya anushthana peksham nishresa phalanto brahma vijnanam nacha anushthana antara peksham. Abhyudaya phalam dharma jnanam. Dharma jnanam, knowledge of dharma, will require you to perform the dharma, of course, but first we are talking about the vishaya. So when you know dharma, what will be the result? Abhyudaya, meaning material prosperity, that will be the result of knowledge of dharma. Dharma will give rise to swarga. So it will give rise to prosperity here and hereafter, or happiness here and hereafter. This is the result of dharma. And there is another aspect about dharma also, is that merely knowledge does not give you the abhyudaya, anushthana apeksham. That after having known dharma, you must actually implement it. Having known truth, having known ahimsa, what all these things mean, they should be implemented in our life, and then alone they give rise to the result. They will give rise to the result, provided we implement it. But before we can implement, we should know what it is. What is kva satyam? Because it needs interpretation. What is ahimsa? It needs interpretation. Dharma always needs interpretation because it is relative. Brahma does not need interpretation because it is not relative. But dharma is relative. It depends upon time, place and condition. And therefore dharma always needs interpretation. Now how to perform a yaga in 20th century when certain dravyas are not available? What will you do? Now interpretation is called for. So therefore knowledge of dharma is first required. Then we will know how to perform and how to interpret dharma. And actually we should implement that dharma. We should actually perform the dharma. Then alone dharma will be able to give rise to result. So knowledge of dharma gives us result only when dharma is actually performed. Tachya anusthana. Tachya means what? Abhyudaya phalam anusthana apeksham. That phala of the result of dharma is apeksham, is dependent upon the anusthana or actual performance. Nishreyas phalam tu brahma vijnanam. Brahma vijnanam is on the other hand nishreyas phalam. Gives us to nishchitam shreya, meaning shreyas once and for all. That one gives you relative shreya, this one gives you absolute shreya. Naja anusthanantara apeksham. And not only that, but knowledge itself gives rise to nishreyasa, and there is no need to implement that knowledge in any way. There the knowledge itself is means as well as end. In case of dharma vijnanam, knowledge is a means but not the end. Performance of karma brings about the end. In case of brahma jnanam, the Brahmajnanam itself is a means as well as itself is an end, because Brahmajnanam directly is a means for moksha, while Dharmajnanam is not the means for Abhyudaya. Dharma Anusthanam is means for Abhyudaya. This is a very important difference between Dharma and Brahma. Now that is being explained by Ratna Bhavakara says, what is Vishayabhimukhyena Udayati iti Abhyudaya? What is Abhyudaya? Abhimukhyena udayati. Abhi udayaha abhyudayaha. Abhi means looking someplace or with reference to something. So vishaya abhimukhyena udayati. Udayati means that which arises or occurs with reference to vishaya. Meaning vishaya adhinam sukham. That abhimukhya means adhinatvam. So vishaya adhinam sukham. That sukham or happiness that arises from the vishaya or the object is called abhyudaya. So it's important. Abhyudaya always requires vishaya, an object. Abhyudaya also is happiness, and nishreyas also is happiness. Both are happiness, except that one happiness requires the vishaya. It is sapeksham. It is naimittikam sukham. In short, abhyudaya means naimittikam sukham. A sukham or happiness for which some nimitta must be there. As long as the nimitta is, so long the sukha is. When the nimitta is not, the sukha is not. And so it is called naimittikam sukham, svargadikam. And so, since it calls for a nimitta, since it calls for a vishaya or an object which is other than you, which is not acquired, you must acquire that object in order to gain that happiness. Abhyudaya meaning happiness that is dependent upon the objects. And since objects are those which are not with me at the moment, in order to gain that happiness, I must acquire the object, and for acquiring the object, I must perform the action. So, abhyudaya is something that is apraptam, and nishreya is something that is praptam. One is anityam, other is nityam. In one case it is apraptasya praptahi, in other case it is praptasya praptahi. The basic difference. Vishayadhinam sukham swargadikam tachya dharma jnana hetoho mimamsaya phalam. What is mimamsa? Mimamsa is vichara. It says pujita vichara is mimamsa. So dharma vichara, you must say before the knowledge of dharma calls for an inquiry into the nature of dharma. Any knowledge calls for mimamsa. To know this particular object, this flower, a mimamsa, what is the nature of this flower? And you know how it is made and whatever, in whichever way you have to make an inquiry to know this particular object. And similarly also, to know the nature of dharma, dharma mimamsa or an inquiry or analysis of dharma is necessary. So dharma jnana hetoho mimamsayaha. Because what jignyasa means vichara, vichara means mimamsa. Vichara is not knowledge, vichara is the means of knowledge. So vichara jnanam jayate. Knowledge is born of vichara. So dharma jignyasa is to understand as dharma vichara or dharma mimamsa, and that mimamsa becomes means for dharma jnanam, becomes the means for knowledge. So dharma jnana hetoho mimamsayaha. That dharma mimamsa, which is the means for dharma jnanam. So actually mimamsa, when you say that, dharma mimamsa gives rise to abhyudaya. How? Dharma mimamsa gives rise to knowledge dharma, dharma jnanam, and dharma jnanam gives rise to dharma anusthanam, and dharma anusthanam gives rise to abhyudaya. All this connection must be known. Then Ratna Pruha continues, na kevalam phalasya swarupadaha bhedaha. One is vishayadhinam sukham, naimittikam sukham, other is nirnimittam sukham. One is apraptam sukham, other is praptam sukham. One is anityam sukham, other is nityam sukham. This is swarupataha bhedaha. Swarup means the very nature of happiness is different. Anitya, nitya. Naimittika, nirnimitta. Apraptam, praptam. So, na kevalam phalasya swarupataha bhedaha, kintu hetutaha api. What brings about that phala also is different. Hetam is the cause or the means by which you acquire that phala, that means also is different. So, tachayri tachya anusthana apeksham. So, not only, dharma mimamsa does give rise to abhyudaya, but then there is a need for anusthana, meaning performance. In short, knowing about khichdi, all the knowledge about khichdi does not make khichdi, you know, doesn't appease your hunger. You must actually make it. So, that is the always the case with dharma, or case with everything that is apraptam. In case of atma, then taradishokam atma vid. The very knowledge of atma gives you happiness or relieves you from grief. Then Ratna Prabha says, brahma jnana toho mimamsaya phalam to tadviruddham. So brahma mimamsa becomes the means for brahma jnanam. Brahma jignyasa or brahma mimamsa, meaning an inquiry into the nature of Brahman with the help of these scriptures, becomes the means for knowledge of Brahman. And what is the phalam result of that is tadviruddham. Tadviruddham means karma phala viruddham. So abhyudaya viruddham. And what is it? Nishreyasa phalam to brahma vijnanam. What is nishreyasam? Nityam shreya nishreyasam. Or nishchitam shreya nishreyasam. Nirapeksham shreya nishreyasam. Sapeksham shreya abhyudaya, and then abhyudaya, and then nirapeksham shreya nishreyasam. That is moksha. Nirapeksham. It doesn't depend upon anything. It doesn't call for a nimitta. There is no reason why that is there. When you are happy, that is called abhyudaya, there is a reason why you are happy. Because something happened, that's why I am happy. But if you ask a brahmajnani why you are happy, just happy, no reason why I am happy. So for him, there is no reason to be unhappy. He is happy without any reason, while a samsari is happy because of reason. That's why that happiness can go away when that reason goes away. In case of a jnani, the happiness cannot go away because there is no reason for him to be happy, and therefore there is no reason why the happiness should go away. Anything that comes because of reason will go away when that reason is not there. That's called nirapeksham. Nirapeksham means that which doesn't have dependence upon anything. That's why they call it absolute and relative, if you want to use that word. So nirapeksham shreya nishreyasam, that alone is moksha. Tat phalam utyartha. So nishreyasa phalam tu brahma vijnanam. And then hetu bhedhana, hetu taha, brahma jnanam cha sopatti vyadriktam anusthanam na apekshate iti. And again, what is the nature of brahma jnanam? So utpatti vyadriktam anusthanam na apekshate. All that is required is so utpatti, brahma jnana utpatti. That the knowledge of Brahma must occur. That's all. For giving rise to phala called nishreyasa, brahma jnanam only requires that brahma jnanam should take place, and there is no other performance or no other action required over and above the brahma jnanam. So utpatti vyadriktam anusthanam na apeksha deityaha na cha anusthanantara brapeksham. Says Purananda here, in the second line, yatha shukti jnanam स्वकार्यभूतायां शुक्त्यधिष्ठान चैतन्य विषयक अज्ञानवृत्तौ स्वव्यतिरिक्तं साधनान्तरं नापेक्षते. सेम स्टैंडर्ड एग्जांपल शुक्ति ज्ञानम. सो व्हेन यू नो द शुक्ति और द मदर ऑफ पर्ल स्वकार्यभूतायां शुक्ति अधिष्ठान चैतन्य विषयक अज्ञानवृत्तौ. What does that knowledge of Shuktika do? What does it do? It really eliminates the ignorance of Shuktika. That's all it does. So, ignorance of what? Shukti adhisthana chaitanya vishayaka agnana nivruttau. Agnana always has its ashraya in chaitanya. So, Shukti agnanam also has its ashraya where? In Shukti chaitanyam. So, Shukti adhisthana chaitanya. Shukti which is adhisthanam, so, Shukti adhisthana chaitanyam, and ignorance of that alone gave rise to the bhrama of the rajatam. And when that ignorance is eliminated, then svavitiriktam sadhanantaram na apekshate. Then it immediately eliminates. So, moment you saw silver, what did that knowledge of silver do? Bhrama of the silver do? It created in you a desire to acquire silver. And from that, the exertion of acquiring the silver. And all that samsara was there. Moment the knowledge takes place that this is Shuktika, this is only a shell and not silver, immediately the desire for silver also gets lost, eliminated, and any kind of effort for acquiring that silver also is eliminated. So that knowledge alone eliminates the desire and effort and exertion and suffering and everything else. And that's why it doesn't require anything else. Having known, you don't have to meditate that this is silver, silver, silver or something, you know. If that is not clear, then you should meditate. But then, once the knowledge takes place, that this is mother of pearl, nothing further is required. And so, Swami Dayananda always is very fond of saying that. That is another understanding, that first we will study Vedanta, then we will go to Himalayas and do sadhana, you know. First we will study this, and then do sadhana. What is this sadhana? I will meditate. Meditate on what? See, nature of meditation should be understood. You can meditate on what? If you meditate on something that is known to you, then what does meditation do? Nothing. And if you meditate on something that is unknown to you, then also meditation doesn't help you. You see? You can meditate on something that you do not know, then also the meditation doesn't mean anything. And if you meditate on something that is known, then also meditation doesn't contribute anything. Yes, by meditation, if you mean upasana, worship, then it's fine. Then you repeat God's name, or you meditate on his form, or that upasana, that is fine. But meditation on something that is nature, of that is knowledge, that meditation doesn't do anything because already you know it. And so, if we think that the knowledge has to take place as a result of doing something, then that cannot take place. An ignorant person can keep on meditating on something unknown, then also knowledge does not take place. Knowledge only takes place by vichara or inquiry. And that means shravanam. By Shravana, what is meant is Vicharaha. That alone can give rise to knowledge of anything. And so Brahma Jnanam also can take place only by Brahma Vicharaha, meaning Shravanam. And so if you think that after Shravanam, then I'll do something by which knowledge will arise, how will it arise? It cannot arise by means other than Vichara. Yes, having now known, then we find that there are certain obstacles which you will remove, like Viparya, Viparita Buddhi. Dihatma Buddhi, then yes, that is not meditation, that's why the word is there, Nididhyasanam. And so, of course, that word comes from the same root, Dhyanam and Nididhyasanam, both of them are derived from the root Dhyay anyway. And still, that Ni is added there, Nididhyasanam. So there is a repetition of Dhyas also is there, and the Ni also is added in there, and that gives you a different character. That Nididhyasanam pertains to that which is known, where the purpose is not to know. Purpose is to eliminate the obstacle, namely Dehata Buddhi or Viparita Bhavana. So samskaras are there. That Dehata Buddhi samskaras are there, and those samskaras need to be eliminated for you to really own up that knowledge, and for that Nididhyasanam is fine. But not that knowledge will arise as a result of Dhyanam. Knowledge will arise only as a result of Vichara. That's why they say, Pound of Punyana, if you think that the Shravanam is not giving rise to knowledge, don't get frustrated and give it up. Because something else cannot give rise to knowledge anyway. Something else can give rise to a view there. If you meditate on some form, etc., it will definitely give a result in the form of some anugraha. But as far as knowledge is concerned, the vichara is required. Sasvyatiriktam sadhanantaram na apekshate tatha brahmajnanamapi svavyatiriktam sadhanantaram svakaryabhutayam brahmachaitanya vishayak agnyanivrittau na apekshate vibhavah. The only thing that the knowledge has to accomplish is elimination of ignorance. And for elimination of ignorance, knowledge does not require anything. For elimination of darkness, the light doesn't require help of anything else. By the very nature, light will eliminate darkness. And so, by the very nature, knowledge will eliminate ignorance. And so, in order to accomplish its task, namely elimination of ignorance, knowledge does not call for any other means or any factor other than itself. Whereas, dharma will require a factor other than itself, namely anusthanam, for giving rise to abhyudaya. So, nacha anusthanantarapeksham. So, Ratna Prabha says, swarupatah hetu tascha phala bhedat na samuchyah iti bhavah. And therefore, na samuchyah hetu tah phala tascha bhedat. So, phala, so swarupatah. Swarupa of the phala is also different and the hetu also is different. Swarupa is vishayadhinam sukham nirapeksham sukham. And hetu is what? Anusthana apeksham and anusthana nirapeksham. Never na samuchya. You cannot combine two things that are totally different in nature. You cannot combine milk and lemon, you know, because both of them are different in swarupa as well as phala. You can combine two things where the phala is helpful to each other and also where the means also is convenient or means also are suitable. For example, roti also requires to be eaten and rice. So rice also you do masticate. And so the means for eating roti and means for consuming rice both are similar, mastication. And the phala also is very similar. Both of them appease the hunger or give you the nourishment. But suppose one gives you nourishment, other one eliminates nourishment. For example, trifala, you know. So these two things cannot go together. Food and trifala, both of them cannot go together because both of them are altogether opposite effect. There can't be samuchyam the two. So, although some people do that, they keep on eating as much as they want, at night they take trifala. You know, that's not the way to do things. The point is, since both of them are altogether contrary effects, there can't be samuchyam of the two. And one thing may require, you know, so then what do these yogis, they do some prakriya, what do they call it? Niyati. This eat, Vamanam or whatever it is, you drink 6 glasses of water and then, now that particular prakriya and eating food also cannot be samuchyam because one requires to be taken in, other one requires to be taken out. So, therefore the hetu also is totally different, opposite to each other, therefore there cannot be samuchyam. So we should know what things can be combined. We don't know very often, and so viruddha, so many viruddha things are mixed up in our life, you know, not only in food but in our habits and everything. Things are totally contradictory, we try to combine them. First of all, husband and wife may be totally contradictory, you can't combine them. Sometimes it happens. One goes in north, other goes in south, etc. That samuchya begins from there, you know. And it becomes very difficult. Sometimes it happens. So that's... But then also we should know what we should combine. That's the reason why we match so many things, you know, in India. And so you match our horoscopes and this and that to see whether samuchya is possible or not. How many points matching is there, you know? Because in which direction are these fellows going? And so, anyway, the idea is that samuchya is possible only when the things involved have similar nature and their means or if implementation are also similar. So here swarupatah and hetu tascha bhedah is there. Swarupa in swarupa they are different and in hetu also they are different. Therefore, there cannot be samuchaya. So why jnana karma samuchaya is not there is very well explained here. That both of them give rise to phala which are different from each other and both of them require an implementation or whatever, which is also different from each other. Therefore, the karma samuchya or combination of these two factors, which are unrelated to each other. So you cannot eat, for example, stones along with rice or something like that, because there cannot be samuchya of the two. Rice and stone, there cannot be samuchya. Phala is different, hetu also is different. One requires teeth made of steel, you know, to chew them. Another one, so one cannot be cooked, other one, so one has to be ground in order to consume, other one has to be cooked. So that hetu also becomes different, phala also is different. One gives rise to all kinds of aches and pains, another gives rise to nourishment. So phala also is different. समुच्चय असंभवेन एक कर्तृत्वं नास्ति इति भावः. सिंस बोथ ऑफ देम कैनॉट बी परफॉर्म टुगेदर और कैनॉट बी इंप्लीमेंटेड टुगेदर, एक कर्तृत्वं मीनिंग दैट वन कैनॉट बी, बोथ ऑफ देम कैनॉट बी इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय वन कर्ता अलोन, एंड देयरफॉर देयर कैनॉट बी क्रम. व्हाट वी आर ट्राइंग टू डिसमिस हियर इज एक कर्तृत्वं. If samuchya is there, then eka kartrukatvam is there. If jnana karma samuchya is there, eka kartrukatvam will be there. Here we are showing that jnana karma samuchya cannot be, because swarupataha and hetutaha, the phala is different. Now, jignyasya bhedam vivranoti. Phala bhedat, jignyasya bhedat cha. The phala is different, the vishaya also is different. The nature of vishaya, namely dharma and brahma, also is different. So bhavyascha. There Bhashyakara says bhavyascha dharma jignyasya न ज्ञान काले अस्ते पुरुष व्यापार तंत्रत्वाद इह तो भूतं ब्रह्म जिज्ञास्यं नित्यत्वात् न पुरुष व्यापार तंत्रम्. भव्यश्च धर्मः जिज्ञास्यः. Dharma is what? Bhavya, something that takes place in future. So you know about dharma today, and actual result of dharma will be what? In future. So you know about dharma, you perform that dharma, and then alone the result will be initiated, not otherwise. So dharma always is something that is in future, understand? Na jnana kale asti. When you know the dharma, so you know how to perform a certain karma. At that time, dharma is not there, because dharma means that abhyudaya phala. That abhyudaya is not there unless you implement or you actually perform that yaga. So dharma is not there at the time of knowledge. Dharma will be there after performance. So na jnana kale asti purusha vyapara tantratvat. Because there the tantram, the freedom is there on the part of purusham. Whether I should do something or not do something, in whatever manner I should do, it all depends upon me. So karma is purusha vyapara tantram. The purusha has a svatantrata whether to perform the karma or not to perform karma. So while saying this, Swami Dayanandji always will say this, you know. All right, come on, one of you from the audience, please come to the stage, you know. Nobody responds. See, you did not respond, because whether to come or not depends upon you. That shows that karma is what? Purusha tantram. You have the freedom or you have the choice whether to perform karma or not. And suppose two or three fellows choose to come to the stage. Then how will they come? One fellow will walk slowly, other fellow will jump, third fellow will run. For anything, any way you can come. Having decided how to perform karma, then also it depends upon the person to determine how to perform that karma. So whether to perform or not, and how to perform, and when to perform, all of that depends upon the person. So there the freedom is there on the part of the person. This is the difference, this is the nature of dharma or karma. But when I say here that this flower, may you know this object in my hand as an elephant. I am holding an elephant in my hand. Would you accept that? You may wish to accept, because you are great Shraddha in Swami, and you know that the Swami never tells a lie, and that he will not misguide you. But in this instance, you cannot oblige him. Why? Because here you don't have a choice in knowing this object differently. This object is a flower, and therefore you don't have a choice in knowing it in any other way. It is a flower that determines the nature of knowledge that takes place in your mind, and not you. Even though you may wish to know this object as an elephant, you cannot, because it is flower that decides what knowledge will take place. You can call it an elephant, because to call is again depend upon you. So calling or branding this object as elephant has purushavayapaya, purushatantratvam, because that branding or calling is an action. An action is dependent upon the person. But this flower will create in you a perception or a cognition of the nature of flower. And therefore, you do not have a choice to know it as something other than the flower. And in case of knowledge, therefore, the person does not have freedom. Knowledge always is true to the nature of the object, and karma, on the other hand, is only true to the nature of the person. You know, karma, what will be the nature of karma will depend upon the person. What will be the nature of knowledge will be dependent upon the object of knowledge. And this is where the basic difference is. So, ihatu bhutam brahma jignasyam. The jignasyam brahma, the vishaya is what? Bhutam, already there. Dharma is what? Bhavya, something that will take place in future. And brahma is what? Bhutam, something which is already there. Nityatvat, because it is nityam, uncreated. Dharma is something that is created. Brahma is that is uncreated. How is dharma created? By performance, by implementation of an action, dharma has to be initiated and created. Brahma cannot be created. Therefore, na purusha vyapara tantram. And therefore, brahma doesn't depend upon the vyapara of the purusha. In fact, vyapara of the purusha is not even called for. So, brahma is something that stands on its own. Dharma is something that stands on the activity of the person. Therefore also, the nature of Brahma and Dharma also are totally different. That is what Ratnaprabha says, bhavati iti bhavyah sadhyah ityartah. Bhavati iti bhavyah. So that which takes place is called bhavyah, meaning sadhyah, something to be accomplished. Sadhyah means that which is to be accomplished. Siddha is that which is already accomplished. Sadhya is that which is to be accomplished. Brahma is what? Siddham. And Dharma is what? Sadhya. There is a big difference there. Sadhyatva hetumaha. Why do you say that Brahma is sadhyam or something? I mean, Dharma is sadhya, something to be accomplished. Hetumaha says, na jnana kale asti. Because when you are knowing Dharma, like anything, like a particular karma, for example, you know, when you know about it, that karma is not there. Karma will be there only when you perform that karma. At the time of knowledge, that karma or dharma is not there. By dharma here is meant only vaidika karma, which becomes a means for abhyudaya. And so agnihotra the karma, suppose you come to know, you have all the knowledge of it, that karma is not there at the time of knowledge. It will be there when you actually implement that. So you know all about Sandhya Vandana or Gayatri Japa and everything you know. But that knowledge doesn't do anything, because you should actually perform the Japa, then alone that Dharma is there. So na jnana kale asti. If you say that jnana kale na asti, if Dharma is non-existent at the time of knowledge, tarhi tuchyatvam, that means it is a non-existent entity, therefore is it not there. Like Shashavisha, the horn of the hair, it is not there. He says, no. Purusha vyapar tantatvat jnana kale nasti. Since dharma is something that must be initiated by the purusha, therefore it is not there at the time of knowledge. It will be there when it will be initiated by the person. सुस्पुरुष व्यापार है प्रयत्न है, व्यापार मीन्स वॉट प्रयत्न इन एफर्ट, इसको व्यापार एक्टिविटी इसको व्यापार एंड तंत्रम हेतु यस्य तत्त्वतः दैट इज पुरुष व्यापार तंत्रम। सो तंत्र मीन्स वॉट हेतु, पुरुष व्यापार है हेतु यस्य तत् पुरुष व्यापार तंत्रम, वेर द एक्टिविटी ऑफ द पर्सन इज द कॉज फॉर वॉट इज कॉल्ड पुरुष व्यापार तंत्रम, तत्वात मीन्स पुरुष व्यापारत्वात इत्यर्थः। व्हाट डज इट मीन सेज रत्नप्रभ, कृति साध्यत्वात् कृति जनक ज्ञान काले धर्मस्य असत्वं न तुच्छत्वात् इत्यर्थः। कृति साध्यत्वात्, सो कृति साध्यत्वात् मीन्स दैट व्हिच इज अकॉम्प्लिश्ड एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ कर्म, कृति मीन्स एक्शन, सो धर्म इज दैट व्हिच इज अकॉम्प्लिश्ड एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ कर्म। कृति साध्यत्वात् सिंस इट इज दैट व्हिच इज अकॉम्प्लिश्ड एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ कर्म, कृति जनक ज्ञान काले धर्मस्य असत्वं, एंड देयरफॉर व्हाट डज द धर्म कृति जनक धर्म ज्ञान, व्हेन यू नो समथिंग अबाउट धर्म देन इट जनरेट्स कृति। इट्स लाइक दिस दैट व्हेन दे गिव यू डिस्क्रिप्शन अबाउट आई डोंट नो न्यूजीलैंड फॉर एग्जांपल, यू नो हाउ वंडरफुल दैट आर, और मॉरिशस, एनी कंट्री इज वंडरफुल अदर देन इंडिया, यू नो व्हेन यू रीड द डिस्क्रिप्शन देयर इट लुक्स एज़ अ हेवन, यू नो एंड सो व्हेन यू appears sounds like heaven to them. But anyway, when you listen to the description of Timbuktu, for example, then what happens? You want to go there. Because it's so wonderful. Gomukh, so wonderful, you know. You want to go there. You hear the description of Gomukh, then it creates in you a desire for what? For going there. And that will initiate what? An effort on your part. So this peculiarity about dharma, the knowledge creates in you a desire, and desire then creates the effort. Suppose knowledge does not create desire, then effort does not take place. You may know something about Canada, and so wonderful the Canada is, and how these those big, big mountains are there, and big lakes are there, and all sorts of things. And you may see this, or read this, or even see the movie. Nothing happens. It's alright, it's nice to know. But then, I am not interested in going there. In which case, if that knowledge does not create desire, no action proceeds from you. That is why there must be a great deal of marketing involved here in case of dharma. When the Vedas give you description of heavens, etc., they create in you a desire for heavens. And that is how they create in you a need to perform that action. Then you say, I want to do this, I want to go to heavens, I want to experience that. Well, then alright, then perform the Agnihotradi karma. Alright, how to perform that? Then there is a desire to know. So first of all, Svarga Kamo Yajeta, there is a vidhi. When you Svarga Kamo Yajeta, one is desirous of heavens, he should perform this. And hey, wait a minute, this one tells me to do something. Svarga Kamo, because I am desirous of heavens, and therefore this vidhi addresses me. Then how do I attain Svarga? Then say, okay, know something about this Jyotishtoma or whatever, some particular karma. Then there is a pravritti on my part to know that karma. You want to earn money. Somebody says, if you invest in computer business or whatever it is, you know, then you can make millions of rupees. I say, I'm interested in millions of rupees, not in computers. But since millions of rupees can give me, I want to know what is the business of computer, what it is, and then how to perform or how to work with it, and what to do and how to get business. Then you know all sorts of things. And then you find that you are an adhikari, suppose you do, then you proceed to actually do that. So first of all, there is the knowledge, then there is desire, and then there is action. This is the way of dharma. So it is kruti sadhya dharma, kruti sadhyatvat. So at the time of knowledge of computer, there is no computer. At the time of knowledge of money, there is no money. The money is there when the computers are there, and computers are there when you make an effort to acquire them, and that will be there when you know about them. That's why it is said, kruti sadhyatvat, kruti janaka jnana kale. That jnanam generates kruti. The knowledge of dharma always generates in you a desire and generates in you an effort. So So knowledge that generates effort, that at the time of that knowledge, that particular dharma or this, this karma also is not there. So dharmasya asatvam na tuchyatvad ityartha. It's not that dharma is a non-existent entity. Dharma is something to be initiated. And until that initiation takes place, dharma is not there. That's why we say dharma is bhavyah. Says Purnanya, dharmasya kritisadhyatvad kruti janaka dharma jnana kale dharmasya asatvam ityartha. All right, that's the same thing. Brahmana dharmad vailakshanyam ihatu idi. Then Bhashyakara said, ihatu. Iha means what? Uttar mimamsayam. That was pura mimamsa dharma. This is uttar mimamsayam. Tu. Bhutam brahma. Bhutam means what? Asadhyam. Bhutam means that which is already there. Bhavya is bhavati idi bhavya. That which is yet to take place. Bhutam is that which is already a fact. So bhutam means asadhyam. Not something to be accomplished, something that is already accomplished. Why is it so? Tatra hetuma hetuhu nityatvat. Nitya means that which is uncreated. Brahma being that which is uncreated is already there even at the time of knowledge. Dharma which is to be created is not there at the time of knowledge, but Brahma that is uncreated is already there at the time of knowledge. And so knowledge will take place. Knowledge of Swarga will take place when you actually go there. Knowledge because it is not there, and knowledge of Brahma will take place right now because it is there. Swarga is something to be created and Brahma is something that is uncreated, and so knowledge of Swarga will take place when you actually go there. And when will you go there? When you perform the karma. When will you perform the karma? When you know about karma. When will you know about karma? When you perform the vichara. So dharma mimamsa will give rise to dharma jnanam, that will give rise to dharma anusthanam, that will give rise to dharma phalam, and that will give rise to knowledge of that phala. On the other hand, Brahma being already there, that at the very time of knowledge, there is Brahma being there, that jnanam takes place. At the very time of vichara, the knowledge takes place. There is no vyavadhanam. In case of dharma, there is vyavadhanam between jnanam and actual experience. In case of Brahma, there is no vyavadhanam between jnanam and actual experience. Therefore, both are one. In case of dharma, jnanam is different, experience is different. In case of Brahma, jnanam is one, experience is the same. Nityatva means sadasattvad. And therefore, Brahma jnanam or Brahma is different as Vishaya also. Okay. And now Purusha Vyapara Tantram. As we just said, Brahma jnanam will depend on Brahman and not upon Purusha. Because it is already there. So you have to know it as it is. You don't have a choice to know it differently. Na Purusha Vyapara Tantram. And that is how Jignyasa Bheda or Vishaya Bheda is pointed out. Sadhya Asadhya Tvena Dharma Brahmanoho Swaru Bheda Muktva Hetu Topyaha Na Iti. Same thing. Hetu means Na Purusha Vyapara Tantram. That Hetu also is different. In one case, Hetu is Purusha Vyapara, other case, it is not there. So, dharmat kruti adhinam na ityartha. It doesn't depend upon kruti or karma. Then, manatopi bhedamaha. A different, a third kind of difference between dharma and brahma. So, phala bheda is there, jignyasya bheda is there, and mana bheda is there. Says Puranandya Nanu Anushthanam Vina Dharmotpatti Abhave Dharma Jnanam Kathamiti Chetna. That is okay. That is not the... Now Jignyasya Bhede Hetvantara Paratvena Uttarabhasham Avataradi Man Gopi. Meaning Prameyoho Dharma Brahmanoho Pramana Bhedadabhi Bhedamaha Ityarthaha. Maya means Pramanam, the means of knowledge. So the means of knowledge of both are also different. Why are they different? Because Prameya is different. So depending upon the kind of object, the means of knowing that object also will be different. Therefore, if the means of knowledge are different, then you know that the object of knowledge also is different. So Mana means Pramanam, meaning the means of knowledge, they being different in case of Dharma and Brahma, that also establishes the distinction between Dharma and Brahma, which is Prameya. It says Prameyoho Dharma Brahmanoho प्रमाण भेदादपि भेदम्। धर्म एंड ब्रह्म आर बोथ प्रमेय मीनिंग द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ नॉलेज दैट विच इज टू बी नोन एंड हाउ आर दे नोन द मीन्स ऑफ नॉलेज बीइंग डिफरेंट द प्रमेय और द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ नॉलेज ऑल्सो इज डिफरेंट सो हियर मान भेद मीनिंग द मीन्स ऑफ नॉलेज द डिफरेंस इन मीन्स ऑफ नॉलेज between dharma jnanam and brahma jnanam is pointed out to point out the distinction between prameya which is dharma and brahma says bhashyakara chodana iti says here chodana pravritti bhedacha even chodana pravritti bheda what is this ajnata jnapakam vakyam atra chodana अज्ञातज्ञापकम् वाक्यम् एनी वाक्यम् दैट इज अ मीन्स ऑफ प्रमाण मीन्स अज्ञातज्ञापकम् प्रमाणम् प्रमाण मीन्स ऑफ नॉलेज दैट मेक्स यू नो समथिंग व्हिच इज नॉट नोन सो आईज इयर्स ऑल ऑफ दीज आर प्रमाणम् बिकॉज दे गिव अस नॉलेज ऑफ समथिंग दैट इज नॉट नोन एंड सो सो वेद वाक्याद आर प्रमाणम् विथ रेफरेंस अपौरुषेय विषय विथ रेफरेंस टू पौरुषेय विषय द प्रमाण आर द मीन्स ऑफ अवर इंद्रियाज एंड माइंड एटसेट्रा But the reference apaurusha vishaya, meaning all those vishayas, mainly dharma and brahma, both of which are beyond the sense perception, and both of which are beyond the human intellect. For them the means of knowledge is Vedas. Therefore Vedas have validity or the pramanyam in two subject matters, one is dharma, other is brahma. Dharma also you cannot determine, because it requires the knowledge of the whole cosmos to know what law. Dharma means a fundamental law. And to know that fundamental law requires the knowledge of the whole creation, which is not possible for us. And therefore, dharma which is based, even the individual thing that they ask you to do, when they say that you speak truth, or don't hurt anybody, or don't eat meat, or don't drink alcohol, suppose when these little instructions are given, all the instructions are basically derived from that fundamental dharma. So dharma is only one. धारणा धर्म धारयती इति धर्मः दैट विच सस्टेन्स अ होल यूनिवर्स एंड द हार्म दैट हार्मनी अलोन इज कॉल्ड धर्म बट दैट हार्मनी व्हेन एक्सप्रेस्ड इन अवर डिफरेंट सिचुएशंस बिकम्स धर्म इन दैट पर्टिकुलर सिचुएशन सो सत्यम वद धर्मम चर ऑल ऑफ दिस इंस्ट्रक्शंस आर अल्टीमेटली डिराइव फ्रॉम द फंडामेंटल धर्म सो यू विल नो व्हाट इज द राइट थिंग इन अ गिवन सिचुएशन प्रो ओनली व्हेन यू नो द फंडामेंटल धर्म And that dharma you will know only when you are sarvajna or omniscient. Since we are not, therefore for dharma also we have to depend upon scriptures. So dharma also is apaurusha and brahma of course is apaurusha because brahma can never become the object of knowledge of the senses etc. And so here therefore that vakya, veda vakya also is called pramanam because it makes us know something that was not known by us. अज्ञात ज्ञापकम प्रमाण सो बाय द वर्ड चोदना इज मेंट हियर दैट वाक्य ऑफ द वेदा व्हिच गिव्स यू नॉलेज ऑफ समथिंग दैट यू डिड नॉट नो फॉर एग्जांपल व्हेन दे गिव यू अ नॉलेज ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर कर्म व्हिच बिकम द मीन्स फॉर हेवंस देन इट इज समथिंग दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल फॉर यू टू नो एंड फॉर दैट द मीन्स ऑफ नॉलेज इज ओनली वेदास प्रवृत्ति भेदाच तस्याः प्रवृत्ति बोधकत्वम So what do these vakyas do? Bodhakatvam. They give you knowledge. So nature of the satyam jnanam anantam brahma. That's a vakya. What does it do? It gives you knowledge of Brahman. So what's the pravritti of this vakya? Bodhakatvam. And so there are a set of vakyas of the nature of vidhi and nisheda which gives you knowledge of dharma. And there are vakyas such as tattvamasi or aham brahmasmi which gives you knowledge of Brahma. They say that these two vakyas are also of different nature. In one case, vidhi and nishida is involved. Do this and don't do that. So that is the vakya for giving the knowledge of dharma. And tattvamasi, which simply reveals the fact of the vakya for giving knowledge of brahma. These two vakyas are also of different nature. Because these vakyas actually create a different response from the person. Vidhi and Nisheda is of nature of instruction. Do this and don't do this. When you are told this, it creates one response from you. And when it is said that you are Brahma or whatever, there is a sentence which just reveals a fact, then it creates a different response from you. Inasmuch as those vakyas create different responses in the listener, Therefore also we say that since that pramana pravritti is different, therefore also the pramana vishaya, namely pramaya, also is different. You understand? How the difference is being established in dharma and brahma? Since the nature of means of knowledge is different. Even though Vedavakyas are there, pramanam for dharma also is Vedavakya. That's called Chodana. Pramanam for brahma also is Vedavakya. But those Vedavakyas are of different nature. In one case, Vedavakya is of the nature of Vidhya and Nisheda. In the other case, Vedavakya is of the nature of merely statements of fact. And therefore, since pramanam Vedavakyas are of different nature, therefore the subject that they reveal is also of different nature. That's the idea here.
Tasyaha pravrutihi bodhakatvam tad vailakshanyacha jignyasya bhedaha ityartha.
The manner in which the bodha is created or the manner in which the response is different, that also establishes the difference in the nature of the jignyasya.
Says Puran Yatra dharme brahmani cha ajnyadattvam samanamiti abhipretyaha ajnyadajnyavagamiti.
So that ajnyadattvam, dharma also is unknown, brahma also is unknown, and Vedas make us know dharma and brahma. In that sense, dharma and brahma, both of them become what? The Veda becomes a pramanam for both of them.
Bodhakattvam chodananishtam shabdabodhajanakattvam ityarthaha. Tathacha chodanajanya shabdabodhavailakshanyat bodhakattvavailakshanyam tataha pramanavailakshanyam iti bhavaha.
Shabdabodha, whenever a sentence is said, it creates in me a bodha. And the bodha, the knowledge that is created as a result of dharma vakya and brahma vakya, so both of them being different, therefore we say that bodhakattva ilakshanyam, the nature of bodha, the nature in which, manner in which they create the bodha is different. Tataha pramana ilakshanyam, therefore the pramanas, they are different, therefore the vishaya is different. So Bhashyakara says,
Sangrahavakyam vivranati chodana pravritti bhedacha.
The Sangrahavakyam, Bhashyakara himself explains that.
Yahi chodana dharmasya rakshanam sa svavishaye niyunjana eva purusham avabodhayate brahma chodanato purusham avabodhayatyeva kevalam avabodhasya chodana ajanyatva na purusha avabodhe niyujyate. Yahi chodana dharmasya lakshanam. Lakshanam here is pramanam.
So yahi chodana, chodana means that Vedavakya which gives us a knowledge of dharma. Dharmasya lakshanam meaning dharmasya pramanam. Those vakyas, every vakya is not pramanam. Only the vakya which is of the nature of vidhya and nisheda alone is called pramanam with reference to dharma. Veda, there are so many vakyas, not every vakya gives us knowledge of dharma, but they help. Ultimately, the thing that gives us knowledge in Vedanta also, not every vakya gives us knowledge of Veda, Brahma. Only such vakyas, tattva, masya, which is called mahavakya, they alone are actually pramanam for Brahma. And how about the rest of the vakyas? They all help us understand that Mahavakya. In that manner, they have avantara pramanyatvam. While Mahavakya is mukhya pramanyam. And similarly also, in the Dharma Shastra, the Vidhinisheda Vakya alone have the mukhya pramanyam, and rest of the vakyas have avantara pramanyam in as much as they help us understand the Vidhi and Nisheda. Like Arthavada, etc., they do not have tatpare in themselves, they have tatpare in Vidhi and Nisheda. So also Srishti Vakya do not have tatpari in themselves, they have tatpari only in Mahavakya.
So yahi chodana dharmasya lakshanam.
So those sentence statements of Vedas which give us the knowledge of dharma, sa svavishaye niyunjana eva purusham avabodhayati. Those in fact svavishaye niyunjana eva, they create in this person an activity with reference to themselves. Moment you gain the knowledge of some action which gives you the result of heavens, then it creates in you to a desire to perform that action, and there arises in you an activity to perform the action. So even that knowledge of dharma right away creates in you a desire
एंड देन क्रिएट्स इन यू ए प्रवृत्ति स्वस्व विषय नियुञ्जाना एव देयर इज अ नियोग और देयर इज व्हाट वी कॉल एन इंजंक्शन दैट यू मस्ट डू दिस और यू मस्ट रिफ्रेन फ्रॉम डूइंग दिस स्वस्व विषय नियुञ्जाना एव पुरुषम अवबोधयति ब्रह्मचोदना तो पुरुषम अवबोधयति एव केवलम वेर इज वेन यू आर टोल्ड यू आर ब्रह्म वॉट एक्टिविटी डज इट क्रिएट इट डज नॉट क्रिएट एनी एक्टिविटी इन यू इन वन केस दैट वेरी नॉलेज इंस्ट्रक्शन और वेरी इन सेंटेंस और स्टेटमेंट विच रिवील्स धर्म क्रिएट्स इन यू ए रिस्पॉन्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एन एक्टिविटी और एटलीस्ट रिस्पॉन्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ डिजायर And in you, a sense of kartavyata, that I must do this. Moment you hear that something is happening, something is wrong with your somebody in the family, immediately creates in you what? A desire, I must go there, I must do something. Or tomorrow, some scheme is coming out, some stocks are being, are announced, immediately creates in you what? A desire that I must know, I must invest, or something like that. So all this knowledge about dharma creates in you what? A peculiar kind of response where there is a kartavya buddhi created in you, I must do this or I should not do it. That is dharma. And that the Veda Vakya has very effectively accomplished. Any instruction should be such that it should effectively create in the listener a response of this nature. Then alone that instruction is effective, otherwise it is not. Sometimes you keep on giving instruction, it creates no response at all. That shows that you don't know how to give instruction or you have lost your effectiveness. That's what happens with mothers. They keep on giving instruction to children, Come on, sit down, get up, go out. In the beginning, child does everything because you think that mother is Veda Vakya, Later on, it finds out that there is no meaning at all. Most of these things are useless, Because those poor ladies are already preoccupied with their own activities and then they don't know what to do with this child. So they keep on telling him something, Ultimately, child finds out that this is all, that most of the instructions have no purpose to serve as far as I am concerned. And then it finds out that there is no purpose to serve even as far as mother is concerned, Most of the things are said for the sake of saying because there is she doesn't know what else to do, And soon, at the age of 6 or 8, smart children realize. And therefore, they stop following any instruction from mother. And at the age of 14 or 15, they stop following instruction of father also. It will take a little longer, that's all. But then, later on they say that the parents, they say things, that's a habit, You don't have to bother about it. They clearly used to say, That means that it is not actually a chodana or it's not actually a sentence that creates in him a response. Then it doesn't become a vakya generating any knowledge at all. What is the knowledge generated? Knowledge of kartavya is generated by dharma. Moment you hear something about dharma, then it is created in you a kartavya. Now I declare you man and wife, Moment you say, then a kartavya, I am wife. Now from now on, my dharma. Until now, the same two persons are meeting, But now when they meet, there is altogether a different thing there, I assume, anyway. And therefore, because now there is a sense of responsibility, that freedom itself goes away, really, I think. Formerly they were quite free, and now that freedom may or may not be there. But whatever it is, the idea is that when now a status is created, now you are a wife, now that is dharma. I declare you man and wife, and the fellow becomes man and wife. And so now that dharma is there, that I am man, meaning I am husband and wife. And that creates a new immediate response, that now I must behave in a certain way. Now the wife must follow and husband is in the front, ahead, Formerly they were going together, now it is different. And so anyway something happens in people, really, by which their whole behavioral pattern changes completely. And that's the whole idea of dharma, is to create a new samskara, a complex by which a whole behavioral pattern is created or is stopped. Vidhi will create a behavioral pattern and Nishedha will stop the behavioral pattern. Nishedha means a certain behavioral pattern is there, it is stopped. Vidhi is what? Some behavioral pattern is not there, it is created. In any case, something is created. Some kind of a change invariably takes place. That's why he says, So vishaye niyamjana eva purusham avabodhayati. That niyoga is there, order is there.
And that is how the knowledge, while the knowledge is created, along with the creation of the knowledge, also is created a certain kartavya buddhi. That's what the dharma chodana does. But then, no kartavya is created in me when I am told, you are Brahman. I am Atma, Brahman. When it is said, no kartavya is created because you are tenth man. What kartavya is there? In fact, all kartavya goes away. So far it was said, hey, the tenth man is behind the hill. What happened? Immediately he runs there. Oh, I must go there to find him. That is all dharma. Dharma is instruction pertaining to something that is not there. And therefore, you want to have it. And so, you have the create. There is a response in you of the nature of activity. Or it is kartavya buddhi. You may not go there. But if you feel that you should do something. After that also some people don't do anything. That's then also, but at least... Sometimes, you know, ठीक है उतना दीजिए तो. So sometimes they manage to create in you a kartavya buddhi, but there is not enough initiate within, you know, to actually do kartavya. But this kartavya buddhi is created. That's all that dharma vijnanam does. Then purushatantra vyapara, being purushatantra, whether to actually implement it or not is up to you. But at least what they are able to create in you is some kind of kartavya buddhi. That much is able, they are able to do. As I said, when he is told, the tenth man is behind that hill, immediately this fellow says, hey, I must go there. When he is told, you are tenth man. Then what happens? No kartavya is created. On the other hand, all the kartavya buddhi ceases to be there. In one case, the kartavya buddhi is created. In another case, there is a cessation of kartavya buddhi. Very important. And therefore, the manner of instruction is different. The effect of the instruction is also different, and therefore we say that the objects of instruction are different. So object or vishaya of the instruction is different because the manner in which instruction is given is different, and the effect that it responds, that it creates in the listener also is different. Therefore, the subject matter is different. See, Ratna Bhava gives you another page 76. स्वर्ग कामो यजेत इत्यादि वाक्यम ही सविषये धर्मे यागादिकरण स्वर्गादि फलक भावना रूपे फल हेतु यागादि गोचर नियोगे वा हित साधने यागादो वा पुरुषम प्रवर्तयत एव अवबोधयति. पुरुषम प्रवर्तयत एव अवबोधयति क्रिएट्स ए प्रवृत्ति मीनिंग ए रिस्पॉन्स विच विल जनरेट एक्टिविटी. इवन दो रिस्पॉन्स इटसेल्फ इज नॉट एक्टिविटी, the response is the very root of the activity. From the response will be created activity. Svarga kamo yajeta, when it is said that one desires of heavens should perform this particular yaga, when it is said ityadi vakyam, this and similar vakya, similar to this vakyam, he is prasiddhi, something known, so vishaye dharme, dharma is, so vishaye is dharma. Says so vishaye iti स्वशब्देन वाक्यमुच्यते. सो यागादो वाक्येन पुरुषः प्रवर्त्यते तस्माद् वाक्यजन्य प्रवृत्ति विषयत्वेन वाक्य विषयत्वम् इत्यर्थः. यागादो वाक्येन पुरुषः वाक्येन पुरुषः यागादो प्रवर्त्यते. व्हेन यू आर से यू आर टोल्ड स्वर्गकामो यजेत अग्निष्टोमेन यजेत, इन दैट केस देयर इज अ प्रवृत्ति टू परफॉर्म दैट अग्निष्टोम कर्म. तस्मात् वाक्यजन्य प्रवृत्ति विषयत्वम् वाक्य विषयत्वम्. सो वाक्य, व्हाट इज द विषय ऑफ वाक्य? वाक्यजन्य प्रवृत्ति बिकम्स द विषय. मीनिंग व्हेन इट सेज स्वर्ग कामो यजेत, देयर इज अ प्रवृत्ति क्रिएटेड इन यू टू परफॉर्म दैट कर्म, एंड देयरफॉर दैट प्रवृत्ति बिकम्स द विषय फॉर द वाक्य रिवीलिंग धर्म, एंड निवृत्ति बिकम्स द विषय ऑफ द वाक्य रिवीलिंग ब्रह्म. यू आर सो the tenth man is behind the hills creates in you a pravritti. So what is the vishaya of that vakya? Pravritti. And you are the tenth man, creates what? A nivritti. So vishaya of the vakya is nivritti. Understand? That's why pravritti and nivritti, that vishaya are also different. One is pravritti lakshanam, other is nivritti lakshanam. Purusham pravartayat eva purusham avabodhayati iti anvayaha. So three kinds of explanation are, what is the meaning of these words? Vakya, Svarga, Kamo, Yajeta. So many people have so many opinions about it. So, svarga kamo yajeta, one who is desirous of heavens should may perform this karma. What is meant by this karma? What is meant by dharma? So there are different opinions about what is the meaning of the word dharma. Says, yagadi karana svargadi phalaka bhavana rupaye dharme. What is yagadi karana svargadi phalaka? In one case there is bhavana of the phala. Dharma is the nature of phala bhavana. That phalam that gives the svarga is dharma. Svargadi phalakam. So yagadi karana. Yagadi meaning yaga or a yajna etc. Like agnishtoma, which is karana the means for giving rise to the result called svarga. One people say that dharma means svarga, which is the phala of the karma. And therefore, when you are performing karma, what is ahead in your mind primarily? That result. So you are performing karma because what is important for you? Result is important. And so, svargadi phalaka bhavana rupe. There is a bhavana, all the time a contemplation or thinking or a prompting by that phala, namely svarga. So some people believe that dharma means the phala. Svarga etc., which is phala, is called dharma. But then that phala which is for which the means is yagadi. So indirectly yaga also becomes the meaning of dharma. But what is the primary meaning of dharma? That phala which the yaga creates. Other people say phala hedu yagadi gochara niyoga. Niyoga means apurva. Other people say that dharma means apurva. When you perform a particular action, then apurva or a subtle result is created, which in course of time will result into your experience of heavens. So when you perform the karma right now, it creates what we call apurva. So other people believe that apurva is the meaning of dharma. Phalahetu yagadi gochara gochara misha vishaya niyoge. So phalahetu means what? Svarga hetu. And what's the hetu for svarga? Yagadi, like agnishtoma. Yagadi vishaya apurva. When you perform that yaga, apurva that is created by that is the meaning of what? Dharma. Hita sadhana eva yagadau. Some people believe that dharma means hita sadhanam. That's the Vedantins. First is Mimamsas. This first explanation was by the Mimamsa Vartikakara. Second one was Prabhakara. Third is Vedantin. So these different opinions are there. Hita sadhanam dharmahan. That which you consider as a hita sadhanam. You may hear all about svarga. If you are not interested in svarga, it is not hita sadhanam. When svarga is considered a hita sadhanam, then yaga also becomes hita sadhanam because it becomes a means for attainment of what you consider as desirable. And so that which is a means for attainment of that is which is desirable is called dharma according to the Vedantins, because only when hita sadhanam is there, that pravritti is created. Regardless of what is the meaning here, the idea is yaga adava purusham pravartayet. In one case, pravritti is in svarga. In another case, pravritti is in apurva. In third case, pravritti is in yaga. Svarga kamo yajeta purusham pravartayet. This statement actually creates in this fellow a pravritti. Some people say that pravritti is motivated by the yaga because it is hita sadhanam. Second person says pravritti is motivated by apurva punya that is created. Third person says pravritti is created by the svarga, which is a phala. These are the different opinions. But in any case, when we hear the statement svarga kamo yajeta, however we interpret the statement, it creates in us a pravritti to perform the yaga because it creates an apurva which will give me the experience of svarga. Purusham pravartayate eva avabodhayati. अयमात्मा ब्रह्म इत्यादि वाक्यं तु त्वमर्थं केवलं अप्रपंचं ब्रह्म बोधयत् वो ब्रह्म बोधयत्येव न प्रवर्तयति विषय अभावादित्यर्थः. अयमात्मा ब्रह्म इत्यादि वाक्यं, दिस वाक्यं अयमात्मा ब्रह्म मीनिंग तत्त्वमसि, दैट्स द आइडिया देन. सेज त्वं ब्रह्माभिन्नः इति. सेज ब्रह्म वाक्यस्य तु ब्रह्माभिन्न त्वं ब्रह्माभिन्नः इति जीवस्य ब्रह्मबोधकत्वमेव.
I am Atma, Brahma, even it is said, Atma meaning myself, so you are Brahma, that is what is meant there. This Atma is Brahman when it is said, idea is what? You are Brahma, or you are not different from Brahma. You are Brahma means what? You are not different from Brahma. Tvam Brahma Abhinnaha Asi. So this particular Vakya is like, Tvam Dashamosi, like that. Vakyam Tu, Tvam Artham Kevalam Aprapancham Brahma Bodhayati. What does that Vakya do? It gives the knowledge of Brahman, which is Aprapancham. Devoid of all the samsara and samsara dharmas, Na Pravartayati. In fact, it ceases, it creates in me a cessation of all the pravritti because I discover myself to be krutartha or krutakrutya. So dharma makes me discover an inadequate self and brahma jnanam makes me discover an adequate self. Dharma always creates in me the knowledge of what I do not have. See, there is svarga. When I say I discover a self in me which is inadequate self, which is devoid of that svarga, and so I want to make myself adequate. And Brahma Jnana, on the other hand, reveals an adequate self. You are adequate. And therefore, all the pravritti that can be generated by sense of inadequacy, there is a cessation of that pravritti. So sense of inadequacy creates pravritti, and the knowledge of adequacy creates cessation of the pravritti. Dharma always is pertains to something which is not there. And it creates in me a lack. I discover that, hey, this also I don't have. When you hear the description of a new motor car, what is already September month is gone. So in the United States, in the month of September, the new models are always brought out. So already 1991 models are on the market, on the road. They call it 1991 model, but that thing is actually presented in the September of 1990. Whatever the reason, the marketing reason is there. But anyway, so in fact in 1990, you are actually driving a 1991 model. It's quite possible that some fanciful fellow, by the time January 1991 comes, he have discarded that car. So before 1991, the 1991 model can be discarded. Such great people they are, you know. And so, but anyway, in September you hear that a 1991 Mercury or whatever it is there, it creates in me that I don't have a Mercury. Oh, I don't have a Lincoln Continental and such model. So it creates, that knowledge creates in me a sense of inadequacy and creates in me a desire to acquire that. Then you go to bank and loan and stuff like that and create for you another set of difficulties, whatever it is. You have to pay for that, you know, that driving the car on the road is not free. But anyway, on the other hand, when you say that, you are complete. It creates in me the knowledge that I am inadequate and so cessation of all the activities. So one creates in you the sense of inadequacy, other creates in you the knowledge of adequacy, and therefore those things which create is opposite effect must also be opposite. The idea is those things which create, the knowledge of which creates opposite effect also must be opposite in nature, and that is why also dharma and brahma are opposite in nature. So three ways opposition is being told here. One is that the nature is different. Phala is different. Abhyudaya and Nishreyasa. Second is the Hetu is different. Anusthana Apeksha, Anusthana Nirapeksham. And third is Pramana is different. Pramana means the means of knowledge. Or the response that the means of knowledge, the response that knowledge creates is also different. One creates in me a sense of inadequacy, other one creates in me the knowledge of adequacy. So the effect are also different in me, and therefore also that jignyasya, meaning dharma and brahma, are different from each other. Vilakshanam, totally contrary to each other. Ityavi vakyam du tvamasam kevalam aprapancham brahma bodhayateva na pravartayati vishaya abhavarati. Purusha pravritti vishaya abhavar. Now what will be the vishaya pravritti? The Vishaya of the Pravritti itself is eliminated in the Vishaya Abhavad. Atma cannot become the Vishaya of Pravritti. There cannot be Pravritti with reference to Atma. There cannot be Pravritti with reference to what you don't have. Or something that is other than you, there cannot be Pravritti with reference to you. And therefore, Pravritti Abhavad, there is no Pravritti there. Pravritti Vishaya Abhavad. Yitha dharma chodanastale purusha pravritte sadhyayagadilgo visho vidyade. Tadu atrana kinchid vishayasti
ब्रह्मणस्तु सिद्धस्य पुरुष प्रवृत्ति साध्यत्वेन अविषयत्वादि भावः. So there is one sadhyam that remains to accomplish when you gain the knowledge of dharma. On the other hand, Brahma is already siddham, and therefore there is nothing to be done with reference to that. Jyotishtvam vakyasya tvaya karma kartvam edhi karma pravritti janakatvene purusham prati karma bodhakatvam. When you hear about Jyotishtvam karma, hey, you must perform this karma. In that case, that kartavyata is created. Brahma vakyasya tu tvam brahma bhinna edhi jivasya brahmatva bodhakatvam. And so, tathacha akhandartha brahma vishayakat pravritti ajanakat sabda bodhat कर्म विशेषक पुरुष कर्तव्यत्व प्रकार शब्द बोधस्य प्रवृत्ति जनकस्य विलक्षणत्वेन. सो रिस्पॉन्स इज विलक्षण इन वन केस द शब्द बोध क्रिएट्स डिफरेंट रिस्पॉन्सेस. इन वन केस देयर इज रिस्पॉन्स ऑफ टोटल सेसेशन ऑफ एक्टिविटी. अदर केस रिस्पॉन्स इन द सेंस ऑफ कर्तव्य एंड देयरफॉर प्रवृत्ति जन विलक्षणत्वेन चोदनारूप प्रमाण बोधकत्व विलक्षणम् अस्ति इति समुदायार्थः. एंड देयरफॉर दिस वेद वाक्यस in one case within Nisheda, in another case the Mahavakya, both of them create altogether contrary response in the person. Therefore, the Vishaya of those Vakyas are also contrary in nature, and that's how in the third manner the Jignyasya Bheda is pointed out. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Atmakarascha Kashabdascha Dvavetau Brahmanah Pura Kantham Litva Vinayadau तस्मान् मांगलिका उभाव. ओम अथ ओम अथ ओम अथ तस्मत् प्रत्यगोचरयोः विषय विषयिणोः तमः प्रकाशवद् विरुद्ध स्वभावयोः इतरेतर भावानुपपत्तौ सिद्धाय तद्धर्माणां विसुतराम् इतरेतर भावानुपपत्तिः इत्यतः अस्मत् प्रत्ययगोचरे विषयिणि चिदात्मके युष्मत् प्रत्ययगोचरस्य विषयस्य तद्धर्माणाञ्च अध्यासः तद्विपर्ययेण विषयिणः तद्धर्माणाञ्च विषये अध्यासः मिथ्येति भवितुं युक्तम् तथापि अन्योन्यस्मिन् अन्योन्यात्मकता अन्योन्यधर्मांश्च अध्यस्य इतरेतरा विवेकेन अत्यन्तविवेक्तयोः धर्मधर्मिणोः मिथ्याज्ञाननिमित्तः सत्यानृते मिथुनीकृत्य अहमिदं ममेदमिति नैसर्गिकोऽयं लोकव्यवहारः वेदान्तामीमांसा शास्त्रस्य व्याचिख्यासितस्य इदमादिमं सूत्रम् अथातो ब्रह्मजिज्ञासा अव्यश्च धर्मो जिज्ञास्यः न ज्ञानकाले अस्ति पुरुषव्यापारतन्त्रत्वात् इहतो भूतं ब्रह्म जिज्ञास्यं नित्यत्वात् न पुरुषव्यापारतन्त्रं चोदना प्रवृत्तिभेदाच्च या हि चोदना धर्मस्य रक्षणम् सा स्वविषये नियुञ्जाना एव पुरुषमवबोधयति ब्रह्मचोदनातु पुरुषमवबोधयत्येव केवलम् अवबोधस्य चोदनाजन्यत्वात् न पुरुषोऽवबोधे नियुज्यते It will explain how there is this chodana bhedacha, chodana pravritti bhedacha, the kind of pravritti that the chodana brings about. Chodana here is the Veda vakyam, ajnana jnapakam vakyam, pramana vakyam. Pramana vakyam which gives us the knowledge of dharma and the pramana vakyas which gives us the knowledge of brahma, they bring about different pravritti, different response from the listener, and that response being different. The subject matter which this vakya address also is different, the jignasya also is different. As Purnanandiya said on the page 76, Jyotishto vakyasya tvaya karma kartavyamiri karma pravarti janakatve naiva pusham pradi karma bodhakatvam. Jyotishto vakyasya, any vakya, such as Jyotishto vakya. Jyotishto vena svargamo yajeta. One desire of heavens should perform this Jyotishtoma Yaga. Such a vakya, vakya such as that, Tvaya karma kartavyam, that vakya, even though it doesn't say that you should do this, it only says Svarga kamo yajeta. The one desire of heavens should perform this. But the result is what? As though you are being told, you should do that. Or I feel that I am being told that this vakya is meant for me, that's what I feel. And it prompts me in me a certain activity. So, tvaya karma kartavyam. Since I am desirous of heavens, therefore I should perform this Jyotishtoma. Iti karma pravritti janakatveneva purusham prati karma bodhakatvam. And so, of these vakyas, purusham prati karma bodhakatvam, they give us the bodha or the knowledge of karma. By creating this, karma pravritti janakatveneva, by creating a pravritti towards the karma, these vakyas do teach us, do give us a knowledge of dharma by creating pravritti towards performance of that particular action. Brahma vakyasya tu tum brahma bhinna iti ayam atma.